Today is the day that I give my vows to you. Today is the day that I'm proud to say I do. Today is the day that we become one. Today is the day our life's begun, and I love you. I place no one above you. Yeah. I'm happy to say this day finally came. I see in your eyes that you feel the same way. Just give me a hand, let me put on your ring. You will get all of what my love can bring. I'm proud to say this day finally came. I see in your eyes that you feel the same way. On this day. From the first day we met, I knew that the one I'd spend my life with would be you. We're destined to be, can't change the way that I feel. Till death do us part, my love can't be concealed. And I love you, I place no one above you. Cherish you from the bottom of my heart. I place no one above you. I'm happy to say this day finally came. I've seen your eyes that you feel the same way. Just give me a hand, let me put on your ring. You will get all of what my love can bring. I'm proud to say.
Also recorded that they asked Rebecca if she was willing to go and become the wife of Abraham's son, Isaac. So I ask you, Devin, Renee, Harris, are you willing to go and become the wife of Lamar, Daniel, Davis?
Yes.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
We do.
Let us ask God's blessing upon this ceremony.
Heavenly Father,
we ask for your grace to be sprinkled and to fragrance this ceremony. May your grace make this union not only for time, but for eternity. May the grace of God seal in their hearts their vows that they will take before thee and before these witnesses until the day that you return to take them to your house. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. It is a special time because marriage is God's idea. God created man and woman with the innate need to love and be loved. It was God who brought Eve to Adam and ordained the marriage relationship in which man and woman would learn to meet those divinely imparted needs of each other. Therefore, love and marriage go together. Thus, marriage is the supreme worth that God has given for our happiness. For all of this, it has come from the mind of our Creator God. You see, marriage takes three. To be complete, it's not just enough to meet. There must be a glue to hold you tight, and that is accomplished through God's loving might. It takes three, you see, for the wisdom of God planned it that way, and if we willingly follow His lead, He will show you how to succeed. For you see, God knows no failure, and He's got the glue to hold together the both of you over the stumps of stumbling, over the bumps of disagreements and discouragements, over the rough patches of misunderstanding. He has the glue to hold life together and smooth out the roadway ahead until you both understand and see that it takes three. For Jesus is the author and the finisher of life. He is the regulator. He is the administrator and manager and the conductor of life's best answers to all things. The glue of which I have spoken is reiterated by the Apostle Paul. And he says it this way: love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud and puffed up. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Love never fails. A marriage that follows God's plan takes more than a woman and a man. It needs a oneness that can enable the woman and the man. That's why it takes three, you see. At this time, I'd like you to face one another. Witnesses that you will love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others, you will perform unto her all the duties that a husband owes his wife, until God by death shall separate you. Devin Renee. Do you take this man you hold by the hands to be your lawfully wedded husband? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others will perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband until God by death shall separate you? Your response. May I have the reins, please? The reins are an unbroken circle, signifying that what we have just performed here, you taking your vows, you taking your vows, should never be broken. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
With this ring,
good job, ring,
I give you. With this ring,
say,
with this ring, I give
my life to you.
My life to you.
That's how you're supposed to say it. Yeah.
Father, now God, you have heard the commitments made by Lamar and by Devin. Now seal these commitments, Lord. Seal these vows in the deep recesses of their heart. And keep them there until they see thee and hear thee saying, come unto me, thou good and faithful servant. Bless them to this end, we ask, in Jesus' name. You may, for the first time, kiss your bride.
Keep it PG.
Hello.
That's a lot of years we're going to be waiting for this one. Now we need to get on
with it.
All right, Lamar on three. I'm going to cue you, bruh. You ready? One, two, three. We got a lot of years for you too. First dance.
You don't know how.
Give them a big round of applause, y'all. Huh?